guests, dear colleagues, dear friends, it's my great, great pleasure to welcome all of you to this 10th edition of the Symposium on Navigated Brain Stimulation in Neurosurgery.
So in conclusion, I think we have seen 10 very exciting years of TMS. In our eyes, navigated TMS is among the most important adjuncts in glioma surgery, and there we have already seen a practice change. It seems to be helpful also in planning neurovascular cases, and it has the potential to change the current concepts, especially in degenerative cervical myelopathy.
It's very difficult for me thinking about treating patients without NBS mapping.
If you confirm the preoperative mapping with intraoperative data, you enhance the safety of your data, you feel much securer concerning the extent of resection. Having both types of mapping certainly adds value to your data and helps the patient and improves the outcome.
First studies on NTMS accuracy showed all the same, that it's highly accurate, and that the gold standard is direct cortical stimulation was basically within a millimeter around what you saw in the picture, which is very good. Now, 10 years later, it's completely integrated in the workflow. Actually, basically every patient gets a mapping, and it's done in a way that it's within our routine.